Hi, I'm Scott Walker. Welcome to another episode of Freedom Fighters. Earlier this week, I got into, a bit of a debate on Newsmax with an attorney who said that it was okay for sports arenas to segregate people by those who are vaccinated versus those that are not. While it may be legal, I said it's not the right thing to do. My reasons are based on both freedom and on science. First, let me be clear. I got the shot. In fact, my family's been vaccinated for some time. Tonette got it months ago, as did my mother. Both of our adult sons are vaccinated. Let me be clear, this is not about the shot. It's about freedom and about science. You see, let me put this in perspective. I ride a motorcycle, and every time I do, I wear a helmet. I encourage people riding with me to wear a helmet. But I don't suppose for any moment that somehow I should support a law mandating it. The same goes for the shot. I got the shot. I encourage others, those of us listening in and viewing us here today, to get the shot. But I don't think that we should mandate the shot. Plus, the science shows that those of us who got the shot don't have to worry. The vast, vast majority of people who are vaccinated are now protected from getting COVID-19. And the extremely small, and I mean extremely small number who might actually get it, are not likely to suffer serious complications. Again, it's all about freedom and science. And speaking of science, the United States Supreme Court just agreed to take up a case involving abortion. For decades, radical defenders of the procedure have tried to defend it by comparing it to removing an organ or a tissue. Science, however, clearly shows that an unborn baby is a human being. See, even premature babies will eventually be able to live on their own. The same is certainly not true for an organ or tissue. Standing up for innocent life, it's the human rights issue of our generation. I pray that we can continue to move forward in our efforts to protect life. And by the way, kudos to Texas Governor Greg Abbott for signing another significant pro-life law this week and to the lawmakers in the Lone Star State for passing it. Let's hope others will continue to follow suit around the nation. Finally, it continues to boggle my mind why so many people, particularly on college campuses, so many people buy into the propaganda from terrorist groups like Hamas. Israeli forces protect their children and evacuate their schools. In contrast, these terrorists, Hamas, use their citizens as human shields, and they literally put missile launchers inside of schools. Israeli forces give advance notice to evacuate buildings that may have civilians inside. Instead, the terrorists actually target civilians because they want to invoke terror. And Iran continues to support terrorist groups like Hamas, which also strikes me as even more odd since so many of these woke activists don't have a problem with this, even though Iran has one of the worst records on women's rights in the entire world. And they routinely attack people who are homosexual, even to the point of execution. In contrast, Israel is the only democracy in the Middle East. Like plenty of others, I was surprised to see mosques and Christian churches, along with Jewish religious sites, during my first trip to Israel. When I was governor, I even met with Arab members of the Knesset, which is the governing body in Israel. Overall, each of these topics are reminders of why the radical left is pushing so hard against cancel culture, particularly on our college campuses. You see, they want students to only hear their point of view. We have to fight back. First, to counter cancel culture and level the playing field. And then we have to do a better job of articulating the conservative message on each of these issues. We need to keep the facts, but we need to explain them in ways that also appeal to our feelings. You see, fairness is on our side. Life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Boy, these are things worth fighting for. I'm Scott Walker. Until next time, keep fighting for freedom.